I'm sure you've all heard about this Namibian lady, 30-year-old, who was arrested at OR Tambo International Airport coming with drugs from Brazil, and she's a drug mule. So this led to me questioning myself and asking myself questions like, why is it that we always hear these stories of drug trafficking in South Africa? Why is South Africa always targeted by drug dealers? Why is it so? So watch this video until the end. Let's discuss this issue of drug trafficking in South Africa, as well as the Namibian lady who was arrested in South Africa at OR Tambo International Airport. Hello guys, and welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm your host, Titariro. If it's your first time here, hello and welcome. And if you're a returning subscriber, my day one, my number one supporter, thank you for always tuning in, commenting, and liking my videos. If you haven't subscribed, what are you waiting for? Kindly click the subscribe button. It's totally for free. Help me grow. Please subscribe. It's free. Just click the subscribe button. So check if you have subscribed or not. Without wasting much of your time in today's video, like I'm just asking myself, I have seen a lot of stories about drug dealers, drug mules in South Africa, etc. And young South African women always being used as the route, the traffickers of the drugs. And also, we all know this, Nigerians mostly are known for drug trafficking. If there's any Nigerian viewer watching me, forgive me, I hold nothing against Nigerians. But research says that most Nigerians are involved in this business of drug dealing, right? Yeah. So why is it also that the drug dealers from Nigeria come all the way from Nigeria to South Africa to do business? Why South Africa? Why not Zimbabwe? Why not Tanzania? Imagine how many borders do they cross from Nigeria to South Africa. Some even use the road, some even use the AETC. But why all the way? Why not use neighboring countries like Kenya, Uganda, etc? But why South Africa? So that's got me thinking. So obviously, all these thoughts, they came after this recent story which is trending. There's a 30-year-old lady, a Namibian national, who was caught at OR Tambo. She was coming with drugs all the way from Brazil, and she used the port of entry, South Africa. That's also my question. Why South Africa? Why didn't she fly back to her country, Namibia, with the drugs? Why South Africa? So if you know, please comment down below. Let's just discuss this. I'm so confused, like, I'm not confused anyway. I'm just wondering, that's the perfect word, why South Africa is targeted by drugs. Okay, so I went on digging further about this issue. So before I go into discussing this issue, why South Africa is targeted by drug dealers, I just want to discuss the background story. Maybe you don't know about it or you haven't heard about it. So the background of the story is that there's a 30-year-old Namibian lady who was traveling from Brazil, and she landed at OR Tambo. And the moment she landed at OR Tambo, she was arrested. The police were alerted that this lady is carrying drugs in her. So they took her to the hospital and they did x-rays and body scans, etc. And then drugs were actually detected by the x-ray in her body. So obviously someone sorted it out as well. Then after that, she's now in police custody. She's arrested and she's been appearing in the court. Obviously this girl is down. We are talking like 15 years or even more. Drugs, guys, it's a serious deal. Please don't engage. No matter how hard life is, never deal in drugs. We'll talk about that later. So I just gave you a background of how I came about with this video. So I was just reading this story and it's trending. You all know it, or if you don't know it, I've told you the background of the story. Now, this led me to start thinking, why South Africa? It's not even a South African national. This is a Namibian national. She was coming all the way from Brazil, but they decided to use OR Tambo International Airport in South Africa. Why not Zimbabwe? Why not Namibia? So that's my question. Why is South Africa always targeted? We all know most of the tycoons of the drug dealings are Nigerians. Why is it that they decide to come to South Africa? Why not Zimbabwe? Why not Uganda? Why not Kenya? How many borders are they traveling? The distance from Nigeria to South Africa. Not even South Africa, like Nigerians alone. We know Brazil, like we know Thailand, etc. All those countries are well known for drugs. Why? Why do those drug dealers target South Africa? So please comment down below. What's your thought? Let's discuss. But for now, let me discuss. I did my own research to try to answer this question. Because obviously, when you ask yourself questions, you have to find answers, right? I found some answers. So first of all, they say that I read an article about this issue. Some people also raised some questions and they wrote articles about it. It's all over the internet. You can Google yourself. So first of all, it's the geographical location. So drug dealers from Asia, Europe, all those parts of the world, they want to do drug trafficking in Africa, right? So because South Africa is a port of entry like the sea, it makes it as a the target. But drugs, some they come via the sea, and they say via the sea it's much easier as compared to the airport. So when they come via the sea, we have port of entry like Durban, etc. And obviously when they arrive, they bribe etc. So South Africa is also believed like the bribing works, you get it, at this port of entry. So the likes of Zimbabwe, the likes of Zambia, we don't have the ocean, we don't have the port of entry. So that's why South Africa. Also, we have the OR Tambo. It's a flexible airport in Africa. It's very functional. So it's easy to connect routes. That's the first reason why drug dealers target South Africa. Then secondly, it's believed that there is high demand for drugs in South Africa. This is real. You all know it. In your locations, you know those boys would do drugs. You know those young ladies who do drugs. So in South Africa, because of various factors, we have our youth being involved in the use of drugs. So obviously, if the drug dealers bring the drugs in South Africa, there is market. There are people who use drugs. So that's it, you get it. Then also we have economic factors. There is also a high unemployment rate in South Africa. And that's when we see mostly the young ones, the ladies. We see our young ladies working for those drug dealers. They are used to traffic drugs, etc. Mostly South African ladies. I'm talking from, I know, like I've seen the stories, etc. People who were arrested, people who were caught. South African ladies, they're all over the prisons, Brazil, Thailand, etc. Why? Because of unemployment. They're not employed, most of them. So they end up being desperate and loving things. You end up engaging yourself in drug dealers and you're now used as a trafficker. You get that's it. Then also, we have weak law enforcement. This is not me, but that's what the article I read said. There is weak. Let me show you. You see, the article I read, guys, it says that weak law enforcement. So this article analyzed and said that the officers in South Africa, they are prone to bribe. So maybe they catch someone with drugs. That person can just bribe the police and they can go get away free with that. So because of the weak law enforcement, people are not that scared, you know, they can risk it. Then also another factor is that, oh sorry guys, let me just check the last part of the article. So we also have organized crime networks. So it said that existing networks of organized crime facilities, the movement and distribution of drugs is very active in South Africa. There is also collaboration with local gangs. International traffickers often collaborate with local gangs, expanding their reach and influence. We all know this. We have gangsterism in South Africa. We have gangs. Let's talk the likes of Cape Town, Durban, etc. So those gangsters, they're the ones who also open the market for the international traffickers. They already find the market for them. They're the ones who also buy these drugs, etc. You get it? In Zimbabwe, I don't know, but I don't know much about gangs in Zimbabwe. I don't know if we have gangs, but where I grew up, we don't have gangs. I'm just saying. But in South Africa, gangs, gangsterism is quite common. Then last but not least, cultural factors. Normalization of drug use. In some communities, drug use may be more socially acceptable, further driving demand. So this article is saying that in South Africa, the use of drugs has become a bit normal. We normalize it, like it's not a shock. If you hear that someone is using drugs, we don't get shocked. I'm just comparing it to Zimbabwe. Don't come after me, but in Zimbabwe, the use of drugs is not common. It's not normal. But South Africans have normalized the use of drugs. So because of that, in a way, it promotes drug use. Then, in conclusion, South Africa's unique combination of geographical, economic, and social factors creates an environment that is appealing to drug traffickers, posing significant challenges for law enforcement and public health. So guys, this is what I found. Like I said, the curiosity came after when I read the news or the article on the Namibian lady who was arrested at OR Tambo in South Africa. Then I was like, why is it that I'm always seeing this news about drug dealers in South Africa and drugs? It's very rare for you where I come from in Zimbabwe to hear people about drugs. It's very rare. But here in South Africa, it's always happening. Then I got curious. I was like, what's wrong with South Africa? What happened? That's when I did a research. I had to answer myself. I had to find answers. So I decided, let me do this video and share answers with you guys. Also, feel free to comment down below. Share your answers with me. What do you think? Am I wrong? Am I right? Anyways, if you've watched this far, thank you for watching. I appreciate your continued support. See you in my next video. Don't forget to like, comment, and to subscribe.